Welcome to Buy, Hold, Sell, brought to you by Livewire Markets. My name is Bella Kidman, and today we're not going to discuss one, we're not going to discuss two, we're going to be discussing six ETF ideas for your portfolio. We'll be discussing two core and four satellites for some sizzle. And to help me discuss this today, I'm joined by two men that eat, sleep and breathe ETFs. I've got Adam Dawes from Shaw & Partners and James Whelan from VFS Group. James, first up, we have the Vanguard Global Value Active ETF, really capitalising on that move from growth into value stocks. Buy, hold or sell?
Buy. Really happy to say that I'm a buy on this one. So Vanguard do fantastic work. Now, the simple reason for this is that inflation's going up, yields are going up. When yields go up, you want to own value stocks. And those growth stocks, that this is the rotation from growth to value. They are active, which means that they actually went overweight financials by 13%. And as the financial rally has happened over the last few months, this one has rallied and will continue to do so in 21.
Adam, for years nobody wanted to touch value and now we're bathing in it.
Now we're back.
Buy, hold or sell on this ETF?
Yeah, look, it's a buy from me as well. I think it sits really nicely in a portfolio, and especially with the thematic of this transferring of tech or sell down of this tech stocks.
Well, next up, it's in the name. It's the iShares Core S&P ASX 200, giving investors exposure to the biggest Australian companies. Buy, hold or sell?
Yeah, look, for me, this is a hold. I use another ETF, which is the BetaShares A200 series. The only reason why is that they have one of the lowest MERs in the market at sort of 7 basis points. So for me, when you're looking at an index, an ASX 200, I prefer to go somewhere where it's a little bit cheaper.
There's not much more reliable than the Australian share market, they say. So buy, hold, sell on this ETF.
For us, with our allocation, we like to be equal weighted when it comes to the Australian market. So it's not completely weighted towards banks and resources. So the VanEck equal weighted ETF, which is MVW is the stock code, is where we go into. But this one is fine too. So that's, you know, hold is for me.
Okay, gents, get your plates ready, get your tomato sauce out. We're going to do some sizzling satellite ETFs.
First up,
we've got the VanEck Gaming and Esports ETF, and this is giving investors exposure to the biggest game developers in the world. Buy, hold or sell?
For now, sell, but long-term, buy, because as the reopening trade is going on, more people out, it's going to be more the restaurant theme, it's going to be more the active, the sports, actual real sports theme. Esports was doing great in the pandemic. It will come back. That's when I'd want to be owning it.
Adam, we're right on the cusp of a huge growth thematic here, but are investors, should they be wary about getting played by this ETF?
ESPO is a buy from me. It listed at $10. It went up to 12. It's now back to around that $10 mark. I think it's a buy. The reason why I think it's a buy, and I think it's a fantastic business, is that it looks at gaming revenue, and it has to have over 50% of the companies that are inside it has to have over 50% of its revenue coming from gaming. Now that's Tencent. Nobody really understands that Tencent has more of gaming revenue than not, but it doesn't have the Microsoft, it doesn't have all of these larger cap companies in there. So I think it's a fantastic thematic.
Okay, next up we've got AC/DC, and I'm not referring to the Australian rock band here. I am of course referring to ETF Securities Battery Technology and Lithium ETF. Buy, hold or sell?
Look, it's a hold from me. I think this stock this ETF has had a fantastic run. It is really, really good, and it gives its clients exposure to that technology. One of its three major holders is Galaxy, Orocobre, and Tesla. So look, it does wrap up a lot of that market hype that's going on at the moment. It has risen really hard. It is moving sideways. I think you could probably get into it at a little bit more of a discount as the market starts to sell off some of these lithium plays, because it has, I think, been overbought.
This is the juice behind electric vehicles. Is this the right way to get exposure, or should we be better off investing in big brands like Tesla?
I'm a buy on this one, and I think it's a buy and just put it in your portfolio and then come back in 5 years' time and you will thank all of us for this one. So for that, buy and hold it for a long time. Battery technology is the key behind the EV revolution. You can buy copper, that's great, but when it comes to the electrification of the planet, it's all about the battery.
Okay, our next spicy sizzling satellite is of course the BetaShares Hack ETF. Now this gives investors exposure to worldwide cybersecurity companies. Buy, hold or sell?
I'm a buy on this one. I think that when the pandemic hit, it was amazing how quickly IT departments managed to get us all into the cloud as quickly as possible. They are still working to secure that cloud, and that cloud, which we are all working in, is continually being attacked. That will continue to happen as we continue to move into the cloud more and more and more. So just based on that simple thematic, it's got more growth, it's a buy.
it's a big growth thematic. Australia is relatively underdeveloped, but the whole world is onto cybersecurity. Buy, hold or sell?
It's a buy. I can't disagree with anything that James has said. You know, the thematic alone is huge. You pick an ETF like this one, put it in the bottom drawer, I think you'll do really, really well.
Okay, next up, inflation. Perhaps not as sexy as cybersecurity, but important and topical.
Yeah.
So we've got, next up, we've got the Horizon Kinetics Inflation Beneficiaries ETF. They are an offshore provider, so I'd be interested to find out whether you think Australia will enter this market and whether it's a buy, hold or a sell.
Yeah, so it's an international one, and generally we don't give advice on international ETFs or stocks that aren't listed on the Australian Stock Exchange. So for me, it's a hold. But I did speak to a couple of ETF providers today to ask them about if there's some of these kind of products starting to come. And they said that yes, there will be some. It is a big thematic and a big theme, inflation going forward. How, you know, you look at the underlying assets inside of that, they do hold some ASX, they do hold some Singapore Stock Exchange, they do hold some Deterra royalties, which is an offshoot of Iluka. That inflation side of things, yeah, absolutely, I think is the thematic. For me, it's a hold.
Everybody's talking about inflation. It's coming. You better get ready for it. So is this ETF the right answer, or do you think that there's going to be a movement towards this in Australia? Buy, hold or sell?
It's a buy from me. It's got just the holdings that you'd want to hold on an inflationary uptick. It is overseas though. Part of the reason, this is amazing what Adam said, part of the reason why you want to have an advisor and people that are on that front line is so that we can go and talk to the ETF providers on their behalf and actually try and say, I've got investor demand. Create an ETF for me and do it. If there was one locally, I'd be all about it. That's fantastic. But this is a buy from me. Inflation will be the story for 21.
Well, whether you're stocking up on your reliable cores or getting some spicy satellites, one thing is certain, ETFs can provide you with a market hack or two. If you've enjoyed this episode of Buy, Hold, Sell, make sure you subscribe to Livewire's YouTube channel.